Thank you very much, Pontus, and thank you for inviting me to this event. I'm honored to be here with you tonight and today. I will take you through the journey of NIO. NIO is a Chinese internet slash automotive startup company, which is different compared to an automotive slash internet company. I come to that a little bit later. We were founded end of 2014. We have been in execution mode since middle of 2015, so around 2 years and 3 months, starting from a complete white sheet of paper. I will take you through the vision and the actions. Actions is very important because as a startup company, the speed is everything, and so on. NIO, you can say that it stands on two fundamentals, which is very important. I mean, reason why we were founded and reason why we are existing. The first fundament is to shape a joyful lifestyle for car users. And the second one is to create a worry-free ownership for car owners. Then everything we do is in the electrification and electrical vehicles, but that is not a fundament, that's more an enabler to achieve these fundamentals. To achieve this vision or to have this as an objective, I mean, you need to understand the pain points of being a car user today. And we all are aware of these pain points. The first one is the huge productivity loss, which is existing globally. Every medium to high, big city, and the mega cities in China have this situation with huge traffic jams and terrifying commuting time between home and office. We all know this. Stockholm is one typical city, but here you have the examples of the mega cities in China. 130 billion minutes every year we are wasting in commuting time globally. It's bad for the society because it's a completely waste time, and it's not good for us as individuals. There's research saying that blood pressure increase when sitting and commuting between home and office. Heart diseases, divorce rates are increased. And so this is important. Second pain point is the pollution. It's also in these medium to big cities, as well as the mega cities in China. Unfortunately, pollution is not a driver for we as human beings to buy electrical vehicles. It is we are as human beings. But no one can say that it is joyful sitting in a traffic jam and polluting the air. And I know that you're polluting and destroying this planet for next generations. And this is a global problem. Little bit the same cities again. So the third one is accidents. We know that. And it is a worrying element. I mean, a tiny mistake driving in the traffic can cause a huge difficulties and catastrophe, basically. Globally, 1.2 million people dies in traffic accidents, and many more are injured. Again, very negative for society, and for sure also for we as individuals who were impacted with these traffic accidents. The fourth one is terrible user experience in general. I mean, sales and service. Who loves to do service for your car? I mean, it's always terrible experience. And who feels it joyful to fill up petrol into your car in a petrol station? It's a terrible experience. I mean, it's smelly, it's dirty, it's stressful. Should you pay before you or after you have filled up? It's a terrible experience. So what can we do about this? And maybe the main question is, who can do anything about this? This picture shows the most valuable companies, 1997. And as you can see here, this is the big elephants, big giants. Mainly two new tech companies, Intel and Microsoft. We don't believe that the solution is related to this company or lies within these companies. If you look at the same picture, 2017, seven out of these companies are so-called new tech companies. Two of them are Chinese, Tencent and Alibaba. And we believe that the solutions is most likely lipid to do with this picture. The reason why the 1997 picture looked different than 2017 is not only that these companies has come up with innovative technologies, because we believe that this is too simple to think in that way. These companies, why they are so successful, has understood the users. That is the main thing. Not they have come up with technology solutions. They have understood the users, and they know how to they are brave enough to shape new lifestyles for users. If you look at NIO here, as I said, we were founded end of 2014. At this picture, you can see that we like to be a true user enterprise company. And for us, user enterprise is to deeply involve our users in everything we do, so they becomes the real brand owners. And we talk about high-performance electrical vehicles and provided extraordinary user experience. These are investors. And one investor you could also see in the 2017 year's pictures, and that is Tencent. I'm not sure you know Tencent. That is the company behind WeChat, which is the extended Facebook social network, but more than that, it's a social network in China. You can also find Baidu, which is a Chinese type of Google. You can find JD.com, which is a competitor to Alibaba and Amazon. So a lot of new tech company and investors, which only not financially support the company, but also they bring their knowledge around understanding the users and come up with innovative, joyful solutions about how to shaping users' lifestyle. This was the vision. Now we talk a little bit about the actions. We were founded, or we say that we execution mode since 2 years and 3 months. We are still a startup company, but we are a big startup company. We have already 2,700 today talents working in the company without any acquisitions, just pure organic growth. We have offices in different regions globally, and the strategy is to be where the talents are. Because if you should be a leader in some type of new tech area, I mean, talents and capabilities, everything. Shanghai, we have the headquarter and the majority of the people. But we are also in a pretty big office, 300-something people in California, in San Jose, responsible for the strength of what Silicon Valley is good at. And that is basically connectivity, mobile internet, autonomous driving, control boxes, etc., which we in-house developed in Silicon Valley. We could make it easier for us and buy electronic boxes from the suppliers, but we like to, and which is very important, to build value in the company. So core technology, we like to do ourselves, which is pretty important, because otherwise you cannot control your own journey. In Munich, we have our designed styling team, which we believe is the place, South Europe, Italy, which has some emotions when it comes to styling, of course. We are in UK, Oxford, for the performance cars, which I come to later, because UK has some heritage and some big talent pool when it comes to race cars, carbon fibers, and Formula E or Formula One. So this is the products we have kind of launched up to now, within 2 years and 3 months. I will come to them, each of them. We are in the Formula E business. Formula E is the electrification of Formula One. So the first year Formula E was existed, that was 2015. We won that race, or that year. Now we are 6 weeks before the fourth year. And if you look at the pre-season results, we should be around top three or something. This car is this is called supercar segment. This is a car we called EP9, designed and engineered in a very rapid development time. We launched this car in London November last year. It has four world records. One world record is that we made one of these cars self-driving. So it has a world record when it comes to fastest self-driving vehicle. Another record is the one you see here. Why did I show this video, and why are we into Formula E and supercar when we like to shape normal users' lifestyle? A couple of things. First of all, this is emotional and joyful. Is someone here do not think this was emotional? Okay, good. Second thing is that. This was important for us to be part of Formula E and this EP9 development, because it was important for ourselves to prove that we are technically capable to engineer high-performance electrical vehicles. And the third one is to show ourselves, as well as externally, that we are able to deliver. One thing is to have visions, but one is also to act and deliver. The third one is a concept car we call EVE. That is what we believe will be the situation around after beyond 2022, when the cars are more or less self-driving. Self-driving itself doesn't make it joyful. You need to adapt also the interior and other items in the vehicle so you can really make it joyful. And this is how we feel and look at a self-driving car here and what you can do in a self-driving car beyond 2022. The fourth one is the most important one for sure, and that is our first mass-produced vehicle called ES8. It's a high-performance seven-seater SUV, size same as XC90, Volvo, or Audi Q7, something like that. Everything we have when it comes to technology and solutions to create this or shape this joyful lifestyle is in this vehicle. It will be officially launched in December 16th this year, in 2 months' time, in Beijing. A big event, 10,000 people will follow this event, and it will be delivered to customers, the first customer, in March next year. And we put all these four objects, I mean Formula E and EP9 and EVE and this ES8 in Shanghai Auto Show in April. But that was not an official launch of ES8, it was more a teaser. The real launch will be, as I said, in December. How we look at this is four elements, how to shape a joyful lifestyle. It's about electrification, it's about cloud technology, it's about AI and autonomous driving. Not as individual items, but in context, together. So if you look at this picture, which is typically, this is a NIO picture, there's no right or wrong, this is how we look at the situation when it comes to technology and where we believe our battlefield will be to be successful. Y-axis, emotional versus functional, and X-axis, the new tech innovation. If you look at exterior color and interior material, very emotional. I mean, material and color can be very, very emotional, but it's not so high tech. It's a low tech degree. The one of you who are experts in strength of material and structured engineering and so on, body structure or so on. Unfortunately, you are neither sexy nor high tech. But this is a little bit how we see. So don't take it personal. When it comes to autonomous driving, for sure it's high tech. It's a lot of software, hardware, complicated logics, etc. A lot of high tech, but it is not so emotional. Self-driving itself is not emotional. If you put it into another context, in a bigger context, then you can make it emotional. Our battlefield is up here in the upper right corner here. AI. Membership rewards. I mean, in China we have this rent biking system. So when I go for a coffee somewhere, I take a bike wherever it is on the street. I scan it with a QR code and drive. It costs 1 SEK, Swedish kronor, every half an hour. Sometimes I got rewarded from the company, so I pay only 0.5 SEK. Or sometimes it's free. And it's a fantastic evening because I was rewarded. You know, we are a little bit human beings, a little bit childish, but I was rewarded. I can the whole evening is fantastic. Instead of 1 SEK, I paid 0.5 SEK. These things is very emotional, and that is where we believe we will move with our technologies and our solutions. When it comes to, if you go back to the pain points again, traffic situation, what we like to do is to give people time back. If you drive, you commute every day from wherever here outside Stockholm into the city center, maybe 1 hour. We like to give time back to you. Things you can do, things we would like to give time back so you can do things which you have done otherwise if we are not sitting in the car. So this is how we see it. Already next year with this car ES8, we like to give 20% time back. So I live in the Shanghai downtown. I work in the suburb. 1 hour from my place to the office. First 20 minutes city driving, then highway, and then a little bit city driving. During this highway, we believe that, or the objective we have is that 15 minutes hands off from the steering wheel, you can do other things. Maybe not sleeping, but other things like eating or surfing or whatever. This is the technology. The vehicle is loaded with cameras, sensors, and radars. Interior camera, exterior cameras. Interior camera for facial recognition, so the car knows you, and which I come to a little bit later. The second one is environmental friendly. And we talked about that a little bit before. I mean, the stake here in this discussion is 16 million ton carbon emission. If you move from combustion engine to electrical cars. And I said that the user experience, charging an electrical vehicle, is much better than going to a petrol station. And what we do here is that we, through our cloud system we are developing, and through the different variety of charging opportunities, like battery swap or power mobile and home charger or public charger, we can optimize the charging opportunities. So it's completely worry-free for the users and absolutely joyful, and it is no terrifying experience as it is for combustion engine. A safer journey, for sure, very important. And not only for related to the autonomous driving, but also to collect data to the cloud and use that in a proper way when it comes to traffic situation, weather, and everything like that. This is everything. AI. Our AI, we have a name for it. It is a device we call Nomi. It will know you, so it's called Nomi. A friendly companion which will grow together with you. And after a while, she or he, we have, it's up to you as a user how to, she will know you better than your wife and your husbands. It will understand your habits, your mood through the interior cameras and the interior sensors, and preferences and everything. AI is the umbrella of everything. Autonomous driving, electrification, and the cloud. AI is the umbrella. So I can take one example. We will have a dinner or mingle tonight. Okay, everybody join that. And after that, you will sit in your car and driving back home. After 1 minute, you decide, I like to go to a cinema. I don't want to go home. I like to go to cinema. What you typically need to do then is to stop the car. You for sure like to check your friend's recommendation through Facebook. What is the cinema they recommend? Secondly, as you don't trust your friends, you'd like to check a cinema website and check the rating. Third one, you need to still standing still with your car, order a cinema ticket online. You go downtown to Stockholm here, find the cinema. But not only the cinema, you need to find a parking place. And then you need to go walk from this parking place, a rainy Wednesday evening in Stockholm, to your cinema. You go into the cinema, and then you have to look at the cinema, then you go back to your car in this rainy, difficult, you never know what happens when you walk in the evenings. And then after that one, you forget the movie. With AI can do everything for you. You talk with Nomi after you come into the car. Nomi, found a cinema for me. I mean, she checked the Facebook, the rating and everything you recommend. And when you come to the cinema, for sure, Nomi take the car and continue self-driving to the parking. So you can go directly in there. And for sure, he or she also bring the car to you, and you don't need to be wet. And what is the beautiful thing is that he or she will understand that maybe you have a conversation 2 weeks after about this movie with someone, and she will or he will ask you, okay, Roger, you remember this movie? Yeah. Do you want me to remind you about the music which was playing? Yes. And she played the music. Okay. So it can be an also post experience. AI combined the time, friendliness, jam, saving energy, and basically the whole thing is to turn everything into a second mobile living space. That is everything. So that is about Neo, and I have take you through the vision and the action of Neo, which is into the logotype of the company. And thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much. Extremely interesting, of course. And we actually have a question here through Twitter, which is quite good. quite easy. I guess he or she is talking about the car you're launching here in December, and the question is, how much is it going to cost?
Yeah, exactly. That is one thing which we never revealed. We are not revealed yet. So when we went to Shanghai Auto Show, we just revealed the styling. The price is not revealed, so I cannot tell you. Sorry for that.
Okay. But then I have a follow-up question. Maybe you don't. You didn't mention Tesla, so I guess you don't like to talk about Tesla. But an interesting parallel is they too started in the very high-end segment with luxurious cars, fast cars, and it seems like you're doing pretty much the same. Is that the way? Is that the strategy, breaking through a new area? You need to go to the high end first.
Exactly. No, I think Tesla is very expensive, and for sure we will be less expensive than Tesla. So it's still a car for normal wealthy Chinese customers. Around half the price, something like that. Tesla experience is fantastic in California. You have a Tesla, you have a house, and you have a charging port in the garage. And you go there and charge overnight, and then you take it. Fantastic. But that doesn't work in China. So because you don't have a house, and you don't have a garage area, and you don't have a charging port. So what we do very much different to Tesla is to understand the Chinese users and the Chinese situation, because that is very much unique versus in California.
Yeah. But I mean, the strategy in itself to aim for the, I mean, you don't start with the low end segment.
Oh, exactly. We start with it's still a higher segment and the premium luxury segment. So then you can, as Tesla do, you can go down in segment. I mean, from Model S, Model X to Model 3. And that is typically one strategy we will also use in some way, maybe not so clear as Tesla, but it's I think just an electrical battery and electrical car in an ordinary car will not get this shape, this joyful lifestyle. So if you really like to impact the lifestyle of people, then you need to load it with technologies, and that is the reason why you are a little bit higher in the segment.
Okay. Thank you very much for coming here. Very interesting. And we have a little gift for you from Technia. It's